اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب الحشر وقنا عذاب الدين وقنا عذاب الدارين. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم أجرنا من النار يا مجير يا مجير يا مجير. اللهم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. بجاه نبيك محمد المصطفى والمجتبى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وبحرمة سورة الفاتحة.
اگر اللہ نے چاہا تو یہاں پر ضروریات دین کے کورسز کے ساتھ ساتھ درس نظامیہ کا کورس بھی شروع ہو سکتا ہے یہ ممکن ہے مشکل نہیں ہے اور ممکن ہے پوسیبل ہے صرف یہ ہے کہ ہم کوششیں کریں اگر ہم نے کوششیں کی بغیر کوشش کے تو یہ کامیابی بہت مشکل ہے وَاللَّيْسَ الْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى انسان کے لیے وہ ہے جس کی وہ کوشش کرے وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا اللہ تعالیٰ ارشاد فرماتا ہے جو ہماری راہ میں جہاد کرتا ہے مجاہدہ کرتا ہے ہم اس کے لیے راہیں کھول دیتے ہیں ہمارا کام کوشش کرنا ہے کامیاب فرمانا اللہ رب العالمین کا کام ہے اخلاص کے ساتھ یہ کسی ایک انسان کا ادارہ نہیں ہے کسی ایک انسان کا مدرسہ نہیں ہے یہ آپ سب کا ہم سب کا ادارہ ہے ہمیں اس میں پوری دل جمعی کے ساتھ اس کو آگے بڑھانے کی کوششیں کرنا ہے اللہ تعالیٰ ہمیں اس کو مزید آگے بڑھانے کی توفیق نصیب فرمائے اور اس کو مضبوط بنانے کی توفیق نصیب فرمائے پھر میں دوبارہ اپنی طرف سے ہمارے ساتھی محترم مولانا محمد زبیر صاحب اور حضرت حافظ وقاری محمد عیسیٰ صاحب اور یہاں کے نمازیوں کی طرف سے اور اسپیچر سوسائٹی آف کینیڈا کی انتظامیہ کمیٹی کے ممبران کی طرف سے آپ سب کا خیر مقدم کرتا ہوں اور خصوصی طور پر حضرت قبلہ شیخ یوسف صاحب جو شیخ محمود صاحب خطیب و امام جامعہ ریاض الجنہ کا بھی میں شکریہ ادا کرتا ہوں اور سادات کرام میں خاص کر ہمارے محترم جناب سید صلاح الدین بابا صاحب ہمارے حضرت شاہ برکت اللہ صاحب شاہ عنایت اللہ صاحب حسینی سادات جو حیدرآباد ہی شریف سے ہیں پھر ہمارے حضرت منصور صاحب اور جو بھی یہاں حاضر ہیں جن کے نام میں جانتا نہیں ہوں یا جانتا ہوں یا بھول گیا ہوں ان سب کا میں خیر مقدم کرتا ہوں اور ممنون و مشکور ہوں کہ آپ حضرات نے یہاں پر شرکت فرمائی اور ہم کر شفقت فرمائی اللہ تعالیٰ آپ کو اجر عظیم نصیب فرمائے میں ابھی ہمارے محترم جناب نثار پٹیل صاحب سے میں گزارش کروں گا کہ وہ آئیں گے اور انگلش میں حضرت شیخ محمود صاحب کا مختصر انٹروڈکشن تعارف ہمارے سامنے پیش کریں گے تاکہ ہمیں پتا چلے کہ ہم کس خطیب سے کس خطیب سے دین کی باتیں سن رہے ہیں آئیں گے ہمارے نثار پٹیل صاحب اور اس کے بعد انشاءاللہ شیخ محمود صاحب سے ہم خطاب سنیں گے
السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ آئی ایم ناٹ اسلامک اسکالر بٹ آئی ول ٹرائی ٹو سے لٹل بٹ واٹ آئی نو اباؤٹ شیخ محمود الحمد للہ دس از دا اوکیزن آف گیاروی شریف اینڈ دس از فار ٹو سیلیبریٹ گیاروی شریف حضرت سیدنا شیخ عبد القادر جیلانی رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ Sheikh is going to speak regarding the esteem, the status of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is the part in his intention to state about the holy qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The reason is it's the occasion of Gyarvi Sharif. But if we do the Miladun Nabi, if we do the Maulud of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam 24/7, 12 months a year, it is not enough. Because the way that Allah Ta'ala created the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even Gyarvi Sharif and the personality of the Ghaus Pak radhiyallahu ta'ala in itself embedded the personality of our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you look to the life and the character of the Ghaus Pak radhiyallahu ta'ala, how he achieved this esteemed position in the eyes of Allah, in the eyes of Ummah, he is the one who not only practiced the Islam according to the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His days and nights were according to the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And alhamdulillah, there is a one shair in Urdu say, koi andaaza kar sakta hai unki jore baju ka nigah e mard momin se badal jati hai taqdeer. Alhamdulillah, that's about the awliya ikram rahmatullah taala alaihim ajmain, and Ghaus Pak radhiyallahu ta'ala is the leader of the all awliya ikram. So alhamdulillah, in Gyarvi Sharif, Shaykh Mahmood is going to speak about the life of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I want to say a little bit about Shaykh Mahmood. He is being educated in Toronto locally here in Canada, and he also has studied with the scholars from Morocco. And alhamdulillah, he is serving as the Khatib and Imam of Masjid Riyadul Jannah. He's one of the our Sunni markaz there is located in the Mississauga, and it's spreading the light of Sunnism there. Alhamdulillah, he's educating the youths there. He's giving them guidance, and I will welcome him for he's a great speaker, inshallah. So you're going to hear, you know, good speech from him about the life of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As for Barka, say Nare Takbir, Nare Risalat, Jashne Gyanvi Sharif.
العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمنا بنور الفهم وافتح علينا بمعرفة العلم وسهل أخلاقنا بالحلم واجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم أورثنا علما وفهما يا كاشف المشكلات ويا عالم الخفيات، اكشف لنا الحجوب عن وجوه هذه المعاني حتى نطلع على هذه المسائل، واحفظنا من الخطأ والنسيان يا رب، أنت الموفق وأنت على كل شيء قدير. اللهم صل على سيد الأبرار وزين المرسلين الأخيار، وأكرم من أظلم عليه الليل وأشرق عليه النهار، صلاة تكون لنا حجابا من عذاب النار وسببا لإباحة دار القرار، إنك أنت العزيز الغفار. أما بعد، إخواني المسلمين، سادات المشايخ، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
It is an honor and a privilege to be in your company this evening. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having decreed in His infinite wisdom that this group of people should gather at this location on this particular day to celebrate this particular occasion. This is qadar from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not something that any of us is worthy of, ولكن it is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He granted to whomever He so pleases, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, it's the occasion of the commemoration of one of the greatest awliya of Allah, رِضْوَانُ اللَّهِ ta'ala عَلَيْهِمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, Sayyidina al-Shaykh, al-Wali, al-Arif billah, al-Mujahid, al-Alim, al-Zahid, the al-Ghawth, الأعظم سيدنا عبد القادر الجيلاني رحمة الله تعالى عليه. I have the privilege of saying that I have two nisbas to مولى عبد القادر الجيلاني.
سبحان الله.
I have nisba to him through the Shadiri Tariqa, and I have a nisba to him directly in the Qadiri, exclusively Qadiri Tariqa as well.
Is
the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us, and a favor that we are certainly not worthy of. ولكن, just like Sayyidina Shaykh was mentioning earlier, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given us a passport. He has given us a special license. One of the companions of Allah alayhi came to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him about the Day of Judgment. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded to the question with a question, asking him, and what have you prepared for it? He was asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the hour, when is the Day of Judgment? And he responded with a question, what did you prepare for it? And if I am going to tell you what it is, or when it's going to take place, what did you prepare for it? And the Sahabi answered an answer which was representative of the condition of many of the Sahaba. He said, fasting and prayer, not much. When it comes to fasting and prayer, I did not prepare much. Why? Because the Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim knew full well that there is never sufficient amal worthy of Jannah. You can never pray enough and say, I prayed enough salah. There's no such thing. You can never say that I fasted enough. There's no such thing. Walakin he said, love of Allah and love of you, Ya Rasulullah. That I have prepared. That I have prepared. And this was a statement that all of the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim bar none would have agreed with as a description of their own state. That yes, when it comes to the love of Allah and the love of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this they have prepared much. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered them a profound answer. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. Every person is going to be with the one who he loves. That day, the Sahaba say, was the most happy day for the Sahaba after the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to them. That was the happiest day. Why? It's because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling them in this case, your love for me guarantees you my companionship in the hereafter. And what's more beautiful than that? What is sweeter than that? This is considered the Muslim, the believer or the ashik's passport. This is the ticket to Jannah. No one is worthy of Jannah except the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walakin the rest of us enter because of our love for them. So based on this very simple understanding, very clear, unequivocal understanding, your love for Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu anhu is your ticket to Jannah. Your love for awliya, this is not ambiguous. Your love for him radiallahu anhu is your ticket to Jannah. Because, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the believers, he said, "Antum shuhada'u Allahi fil ard." The companions, they were walking with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they passed by a group of graves, a set of graves. And the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim, they said, foul people lay there, corrupt people are buried in this grave. That's what the Sahaba said. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, wajabat, wajabat, wajabat. They passed those graves to another set of graves. And the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, pious people lay there, good people are buried there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again said, wajabat, wajabat, wajabat. So Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu Farooq, he went to Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, we passed by the first group of graves, we said what we said, and you said wajabat three times. Wajabat literally means, it has become mandatory, it has become mandatory, it has become mandatory. We passed by the second set of graves, we said what we said, again you said wajabat three times. The Prophet ﷺ said to him, when you pass by the first set of graves and you Muslims said what you said about the people that are buried there, hell became mandatory for those people. When you all said what you said about that set of graves, the people that were laying there in those graves, you all said that they are corrupt people. That moment, Jahannam became wajib for those people. They have to go to Jahannam. And when you passed by the other graves, and you said what you said about the people who lay there, the people that are buried there, you said they're pious people. When you said that, Jannah became wajib for those people. Antum shuhada'ullahi fil ard. You are all the witnesses of Allah upon this earth. Now the Ummah of Islam, East and West, North and South, Arab and non-Arab, have all come to agree concerning the piety, the righteousness, and the sanctity, and the dignity of Mawlana Abdul Qadir Jilani radhiyallahu ta'ala. We say wajabat, wajabat, wajabat. And since that is the reality of this man, this wali, this friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our love for him guarantees us companionship with him, because again the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab." Everybody is with the one who he loves. And so if you love him, and it is guaranteed that he radiallahu anhu is from Ahlul Jannah, then that guarantees you by your love for him radiallahu anhu, that you will be in Jannah with him inshaAllah. So let no one underestimate the love and the reverence and the value of that love and reverence for the awliya Allah. Radwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. Not least of which is Ghawthul A'la. Now, we wanted to talk about some of the reasons why there is divergence among the Muslims today concerning the status of these awliya, concerning the mention of these awliya, concerning the love and the longing and the remembrance of these awliya. Some people say, no, this is too much, it's excess, it's inappropriate, it's bid'ah. We hear this constantly. So we want to ask, since the matter is in fact, according to the Nusus, and according to the ulama of the Sunnah al-Jama'ah, there's no ambiguity, walakin today there is ambiguity, people are confused. So we want to know what gave rise to that, because the same people who have a problem with that also have a problem with Midad al-Nabi. Same people who have a problem with it have a problem with celebrating the birth of the Prophet ﷺ. Same people who have a problem with that have a problem with dhikr out loud and the majalis for na'at and the madh of the Prophet ﷺ and the visitation of the graves of the awliya salihin radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim, etc., etc. So we want to know, what gave rise to this? There has to be a problem, there's something. We want to find it. We want to inoculate our ummah, our community, from these problems. We want to know, identify them, and uproot them inshaAllah bihawli. And the problem returns to a matter of aqeedah. One of our brothers in our mashayikh, Sayyidi Shaykh Abdul Aziz Pippin, Allah give him long life, barakallahu fi. In passing conversation once he said to me, and he's absolutely right, I love quoting him on this, he said, the person whose aqeedah becomes sound, his aqeedah also becomes sound.
SubhanAllah.
Your aqeedah becomes upright, your aqeedah. So I said, what's the difference? He said, aqeedah is your belief concerning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walakin aqeedah, the manner of expression, expressing the issue, is your relationship with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. SubhanAllah.
If you have doubts in your aqeedah and your understanding concerning the reality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're going to have a problem in your recognition about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You might start to imagine, like some Muslims have imagined, that he's a man like you and me. This is absolutely false and entirely unacceptable. Walakin, I have heard it with my own ears. People stand at the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they say, he was a man like you and me. He died, he is dead. Matt. This is a disaster. It's a complete spiritual disaster. So we have to talk about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his rank in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's our topic. But before we get to that, we want to mention something about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody here, inshallah, is Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, in your aqidah, you have to study your aqidah. And the importance of aqidah has to be brought home by our dear mashayikh regularly and consistently. لماذا? Why? If you make a mistake in fiqh, if you make a mistake in the actions, in the acts of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah may forgive it. Walakin, if you make a mistake in aqidah, in the matter of belief, Allah says He does not forgive it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive that partners be associated with him. But he forgives everything other than that. He may forgive anything else other than that to whomever he pleases from among his believers. So aqidah mistakes are very dangerous. What we found in this day and age, and recently I heard another complaint of it, there's more than one masjid that's doing it. All of you that can see, you can see this says, Ya Allah, Ya Muhammad. You see that? The name of Allah and the name of Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam next to it. People have a major problem with this now. So all over the city, There's masajid that are taking down the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A'udhu billah. They're saying you can't place the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.